Now, if you're anything like me, when you hear Marshall Tufflex, you probably think about containment, plastic trunking, back boxes, conduit and cable tray. However, in this video, we're going to look at something a little bit different because not only do they provide materials to carry cables above ceilings, they seem to have moved into the manufacture of the ceiling itself. We've all been there, installing recessed lights or control points into suspended ceilings, and of course, the ceiling tiles aren't strong enough to support the fitting or the accessory. So the traditional solution to this is to cut a square of plywood the same size as the ceiling tile in question, and then cut a hole in both the tile and the ply. So off you'd go hunting for a bit of plywood big enough to cut a 600mm square in, either having a look at what the chippy has lying around while they're off on their break and hoping they won't notice, or if you have, you know, a healthy working relationship with them and a decent site manager, then they could be persuaded to cut them for you. Either way, it's a pain. And then you remember that the timber needs to be about 595mm square to drop in neatly, and the corners never seem to want to go in properly, and then there's all the dust from cutting the wooden buttress with a hole saw or a jigsaw, and frankly, it's all a bit of a time-consuming, dirty nuisance. So with all that in mind, Marshall Tufflex have created the Tufflex Tile, and to be honest, it's one of those things that you can't help but wonder why it hasn't been done before. It's just a sheet of material called Corex, which has all of these square kind of hollow sections passing through it. This lends the material strength while keeping it really light. So strong, in fact, that it's been weight tested up to 5 kilograms, which matches the requirement for fixing luminaires in regulation 559.5.2. Because it is so light, it's easy to handle and move about site, and storage is really easy as well because it's so slimline. In fact, you can pile boxes of these on top of each other, but don't be tempted to stick them under other items in the van, as that could lead to them getting damaged. If these internal ribs here get crushed, they'll lose their structural integrity and their strength as well. Another installation-related benefit to the Tufflex Tile is how easy it is to cut. You can turn to the hole saw that you would have used on the plywood buttress, or you can simply use a knife to slice through it, and this means that there's minimal to zero dust when cutting the hole in for the fitting or accessory, thus reducing the need for PPE when cutting. And because it can so easily be cut without the use of power tools, that also means that you can cut in circular or rectangular boxes with the same tool really easily, as you can see here for a circular box and here for a square back box. Then when it comes time to volley it into the ceiling, it's got these chamfered corners that you can see here, and this makes it so much easier to drop into place, and it won't get hung up where the suspended ceiling grid joins together. Again, just a little thoughtful touch that makes installation life so much easier. Now, please don't make the mistake of thinking that this is a replacement for the ceiling tile. I've just popped it in here so you can actually see it. The idea is it replaces the wooden buttress used in the past. So we'd cut the hole in the Tufflex tile and the ceiling tile, as you can see here. Those are not my arms, by the way. And then install them both into the ceiling to support the fitting or accessory. And not only is it a lot easier to install, it also has advantages for the ongoing operation of the building, because the material is low smoke and fume, it's flame retardant, and it's self-extinguishing. So if you install this instead of a wooden buttress, you're removing a source of fuel from within the building, which could help to reduce the spread of fire. All this means that use of the Tufflex tile in an installation can help the building to comply with approved document B of the building regulations, which is all about fire safety, particularly in the design and construction of the property. Now, of course, there'll be people watching and wondering if this isn't a step backwards in terms of sustainability, because timber can be acquired from sustainable sources and this is made of a plastic material. Well, of course, single-use plastic is not ideal because it is pretty wasteful and often ends up in places that we don't want it to. But the use of long-term plastics is a little different because it's likely to be in situ for a number of years. And even if there's a refurb and the fittings get replaced or rearranged, these could be reused if the cutouts are the same size or larger for the new fittings. And once they do reach the end of their life, for whatever reason, they're totally recyclable. So I don't think we can summarize any better than Marshall Tufflex do on the product. It's super lightweight, easy to cut, handle and store, pre-cut to exactly the right size for a full tile with pre-chamfered edges, it's strong enough to support 5 kilograms of weight, is flame retardant and self-extinguishing, and there's no waste or dust when cutting with a knife, reducing the need for PPE, which of course should always be the last resort when minimizing the risk a hazard produces. I think it's a really innovative yet simple piece of kit that makes electricians' lives easier, and we really like that at eFIXX. But as always, we want to hear from you. Do you think that this is going to be the next big thing in commercial and industrial installations? Can you think of any jobs or applications coming up that it will be helpful for? Whatever your thoughts and questions, please leave them in the comments section below, and as always, thank you very much for watching.